black like he don't. I know where it's on this place. I got to know the time exists you, but I think it doesn't. Then I got to acknowledge that I have emotions and thoughts, but I think they don't.
Amen.
Jesus.
Wow.
Right?
Yeah.
This is so good, man.
Oh, God.
Glory. I should have run an office and just counsel people or something. This man's stuff right here. This stuff, man.
Yeah.
See, watch this. I got to acknowledge that I get angry.
Yes.
But I got to act like I'm not angry. Y'all ain't even talk to me here. Y'all please say, I don't know if everybody here. I don't know if everybody, I can see everybody here. Raise your hand up. I am a human being.
Yes.
I have been created to have emotions.
Yes.
But when I'm walking in God's eternal plan, emotions can be my enemy.
Oh, yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
So I got to acknowledge, yes, I have emotions, and yes, I have thoughts.
Yeah.
But I got to act like I don't. How do I do that? I stay focused on what God said. I feel it, really.
Yeah.
But I can't act on that. I think you're against me, but I can't act on that.
Jesus.
I think my wife don't make me good, but I can't act on it. I think church folk don't love me, but I can't act on it. Y'all ready for this? You think everybody against you, but you can't act on that because you don't have that much power. Don't know that.
My
I'm not having you all here this morning. Today, I'm talking about having victory in the spirit. I'm talking about spiritual growth here. I'm talking about feeling it and not responding.
Help!
I'm talking about feeling it and not responding. My only response is going to be what God said.
Yeah.
So God said, love your neighbors yourself.
Come on.
You stepped on my toe, but I still got to love you. Because when you step on my toe, my thoughts say, what's up with this Negro? My feelings say, get them straightened. But God said, glory to God, love your neighbor. Y'all ain't ready for this.
My Lord, go ahead, sir.
I lost all my amens over here.
Amen,
some of the ways they get pretty sad when you sit in church. So here's the deal, man.
My Lord.
Before I move on to something else, I'm going to help you all with this.
Yes.
See, you are a spiritual, I feel like, creature of the Holy Ghost.
Come on, preach.
I love you, Lord. I thank you. You are born a spiritual being. Your victory is in the spirit. I already told you all, the Muslims are not you. They don't have the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
The only thing God promised them is wealth. Don't get upset with it because they love you. God told that boy, Hagar, he said, I'm going to make him a great nation. He will be against his neighbors, his neighbors will be against him. That's why they always in war. They don't have the Holy Ghost. They're not God's children.
Wow.
But you are. So you have spiritual and natural blessings. Y'all, I don't know.
That's really good. Come on.
And I don't know why I'm stopping to say this, and I keep saying this, we need to understand the movements of God.
That's
stop
right.
Judging the Muslims. Stop asking them to wonder why they're that way. That's who they are.
Yep, come on. Come yes. On.
God told Hagar, the angel told her, this boy's going to be against all the nations. And people going to be against, he's going to be a warrior. He's going to always be in warfare. They don't know nothing about peace.
Come on, son. My Lord.
And then we get upset because they've been who they are. Instead, we put our focus on being who we are. We have the Spirit of God dwelling in us. The love of God is shed abroad in the heart by the Holy Ghost. You have no excuse not to love people. They have total justification for treating women the way they do. You and I over here don't. See, what I'm trying to get you to understand, you being God's child, I don't finish this thing on strong faith. You're a spiritual being. What I'm trying to raise up, gentlemen, up is a people who will be strong in the spirit. But it's going to take warfare. It's going to take your total trust in God. It's going to take you accepting yourself the way God made you. And stop trying to be somebody that you're not. Because as long as you're struggling with who you're not, you will not be able to walk forward and think of God. You got to know what I'm saying. You accepting me just the way I'm not. I'm accepting it enough. Now I got to focus on being a strong spiritual being. I got to focus on my faith. I got to focus on the promises.
Yes, Lord. My Lord.
That's good.
So now, I have to act like time don't exist.
Yes.
And that's not easy to do, man. Because all your life, you've been judged by time. You're a certain age, you've been a certain grade. You're a certain age, you should be acting as smart as a nine.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Am I preaching good to y'all?
Yes.
You've been judged by time. So you come in this kingdom, and God says, I've already blessed you. I want you to walk in this greatness, so I need you to get on time. Because I don't work in time. And since I'm already predestined your life, it's going to be time to look and I'm not with you.
My Lord. Go ahead.
But you'll never know I'm not with you unless you focus on time. If you go through knowing it's a part of the process, then the time you got to stay in it, you're not going to come. Because you know that someday this is going to be over. Why? I'm living a life of appointments. Good God, sometimes. I knew that the day was coming, I was going to get off a drug. It took a little longer than I wanted to take. But I knew it was coming because the promise had been made. But since I was focused on time, I became guilty. I became condemned. I became embarrassed. I became depressed. Because time was telling me, you should be further than this person. So good. Is anybody getting what I'm saying here? Time was telling you, me, I should be further than where I was. Time was telling you, you're too educated to be out here doing this. Time was telling me, come on, talk to me. Time will put you in a place where you forget that God's word even exists. I'm going to put you in here. We'd be out here early. Am I having anybody here? So I understand now. I got to act like these things don't exist. I acknowledge I have these feelings. I mean, you put particularly you people in these personal relationships. This is when the emotions and stuff are really kicking in. You have to act. You have to think it. And not act on it.
Oh, yeah.
You have to feel it. And not act on it. Now, it's going to make you feel weak.
Yes.
As a person, can I just teach you all something here?
Go ahead.
I talk about people who are growing up, peace in your home and peace in your life.
Yes.
It's going to make you feel weak as a person.
Yes.
But the Bible says, Paul says, when I'm weak, then I'm strong.
Yes.
Because when you look weak to yourself and weak to them, your spirit is being good. I feel it. I feel the Holy Ghost here.
Yes.
I feel. That's why Paul said, God, and my friend, that the power of Christ must rest upon me. So while you think getting over on me, I'm gonna be quiet because I'm going in the spirit.
Yeah.
So when the devil comes to my house, I can defend him all. Why you gotta fight with him? Because I'm going in the spirit. He has a go to a place where what you do or what he does doesn't matter. But I have to look weak to you, I'm weak to me, I still be quiet.
Wow.
Say it again.
My Lord.
Oh, that's the devil that get the naked noise too.
Thank you.
You should get some straightening.
Yes.
You tired of this right now.
Come on, sir.
That's been going on too long. I go in your house. I'm just on my mind. That devil come to you and tell you to get some straight. If God really said that, the same trick. I'm off my message, but I feel like I got to preach it. The same trick he used on Adam. Did God really say that? Because if he said it wouldn't have happened right now. The same trick. God talked to me here. The same trick he used on Adam, he's trying to use on you. Get in your mind to get you to focus on time. I get you to be judging yourself. I get you to, oh God, I'm talking good here. I'm happy y'all just say amen.
Amen.
So, I have to understand that with this blessing that I have, I can't focus nowhere other than the promise.
Amen.
I can't. And if I'm going to grow spiritually, I can't respond to the stimulus of life.
Yes.
See, baby, you live with me every day, and so you better know where I stand in this. Because it's a dying experience. I need to talk to some of you young people. Yeah, but it's a powerful experience, though.
Yes, when you
overcome yourself, prodigal son, when you come to yourself, and you overcome yourself, I know you don't have to respond. I know you don't have to be right.
Come on, sir.
See, this is not for people who weak in faith. I'm talking about people who can be at peace with yourself all the time.
Yeah.
Because you're not trying to control.
Right.
You're not trying to manipulate. Y'all talk to me here. You're not trying to fix everything. You trust God to tell the plan for your life. And then that way it was supposed to go that way. I don't have to stop my journey and fix that just because I don't like it. And just because I think it's getting over me. And just because, come on, y'all talk to me here, somebody.
Right.
Oh, that's why we have so many people in church that's just full of weakness.
My Lord.
Because we're suddenly trying to control everything.
Come on, sir. Amen.
And we're manipulating everything. And when I'm trying to control it, I take God's hands off of it, basically. I'm saying I don't trust that this is supposed to be happening to me right now. You know why? Because I'm focused on time. Boy, this stuff is good here.
Go ahead, sir.
Hear what I'm saying to you. Hear what I'm telling you, because